apart from my bridal lehenga, every other lehenga that I wore for my wedding functions, I had DIY'd them. Hey guys, I'm Pratibha. Welcome back to my channel. Weddings are the most important events of our lives. We want everything to be perfect. Our shoes, our makeup, our outfits, pictures and whatnot. So today I'm going to give you some tips that will help you and make this whole process a little easy. I'll also talk about my experience while planning my own wedding. Let's get started. Weddings can be pretty expensive, so plan your budget. My first tip for this will be make a list of things where you need to spend your money on. Your list can include jewelry, footwear, skincare. Yes, you need to include skincare as well because the beauty treatments out there can be pretty expensive. And last but not the least, your outfits. There are just so many functions for which you need to plan your outfits. You've got haldi, sangeet, your wedding day, reception and your pre-wedding shoot. In case you guys are interested, I've made an entire series on pre-wedding shoot. I will link it somewhere over here or in the description box below. You have the list ready and it's time for you to allocate the budget. So here comes my tip number two. Check online and visit the local stores. It will help you to know what are the latest designs in the market for your outfits, your jewelry and even your footwear. And it will help you to know the price range for each of these items. When I went for my wedding shopping, I had no idea how expensive these things can be, especially the bridal lehengas. Everything was way beyond what I had expected and I was not willing to pay so much for an outfit that I'm gonna wear probably once or twice in my life. And another thing was that I was going to all these big stores, so I decided to take a different route. I went to a smaller store here in Hyderabad and I got a bridal lehenga from there and it costed me way less than these expensive lehengas from these big stores. They even customized the lehenga for me and I was really happy with how it turned out. So it's possible that you can get good quality and good designs out there in local stores as well. Definitely give it a try, guys. It's worth it. So let's say you did not find your outfit in the big or the smaller stores in your area, then you still have an option to go online. There are a lot of people who have tried online bridal or wedding lehengas. I haven't personally tried them, so I can't really talk about it much, but definitely check that out. You can even rent out a lehenga or an outfit in case you don't find anything, or you can even DIY them. So apart from my bridal lehenga, every other lehenga that I wore for my wedding functions, I had DIY'd them. I've even made a video on how I DIY'd my mehndi lehenga. I'll put a link over here. Definitely check it out. But if you're interested and you would like to know more about the other outfits that I had designed for my sister and myself, please leave a comment down below and I would love to make a video for you guys. If you're still watching this video, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I started my wedding preparation 6 months before the wedding and I still had some pretty stressful situations. Save yourselves from situations like you wanting to change the design or your outfit is not ready on time. So all of this can be avoided if you start a little bit early and give yourself some buffer time. In my case, I did not like my blouse for my bridal lehenga and I wanted to make some changes to the design. Just because I had some buffer time and I started early, I could make changes to it and I was really happy. I did not have to compromise, so I can't stress enough for you to give yourself a little buffer time to make changes. And this starting early applies to both your skincare and hair care as well. You would have seen out there that the bridal treatments start 3 months before the wedding. Your skin needs time to heal. You would have heard that don't try any new cosmetic or a new beauty treatment just before your wedding. It could react and you will not have enough time for your skin to heal. So if you start early, you would know that it reacts and you'll have time to rectify in case there is a problem. Right, so definitely try to give yourself a little more time. And if you're one of those people who want to probably lose weight or gain weight, then starting early is the key. You want to lose or gain weight in a healthy way, right? Another tip that I can give you guys is Make your bookings in advance, be it your makeup artist, your skincare consultation, or your jewelry. It's highly possible that the makeup artist that you want for your wedding day is busy or is already booked, or the jewelry goes out of stock. So book all of them in advance. And that's it, guys. I hope you guys like this video. And if you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below if you want me to make more of these kind of videos. And subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye-bye.